ladies and gentlemen, Tony Orlando and Dog.
Make me cry. I'll never frighten your worry. I know I'll always get by. I heat up.
I cool down.
When something gets in my way, I go round it. Don't let life get me down. Gonna take it the way that I found it.
Didn't you notice something different about me tonight?
Let's see. Hair, yeah. Mustache, check. Tight pants. Everything looks okay to me. You want me to check up under your hood?
No. Checking under the hood is my job. Now, that should give you a hint. Grease, oil.
Grease, oil. I've got it. You styled your hair.
Didn't my singing sound different tonight?
It's hard to say.
Why?
We never listen.
Quiet, mammoth mouth.
That's our Tony.
Okay, have it your own way. I'll just go ahead and introduce our guests. First, the young lady who stars as Maude's daughter, the glamorous Adrienne Barbeau. And now I want to present a brilliant young comedy talent. From Chico and the Man, one of the truly great and outstanding young men that's ever been my pleasure to see on any stage in America. Did I say America? Nay, the world. Let's have a warm welcome for a man, credit to his race, good to his folks. Great, great comedy genius. Mr. Freddie Prinze.
Looking good.
Yeah. There you go.
Hello, for fibers. See. Well, it's wonderful to be here. Yes, indeed, for the birth of a new act. Tony Orlando and Dawn has just become Chico and the Chicklets.
Man, the girls didn't even notice it was me out here instead of you.
That's right. There's a lady out there that says, oh, yes, we did, because Freddie and I planned this whole thing to fool
That's right.
You girls, I mean, you really can't tell the difference between Freddie Prinze and myself.
Frankly, guys, you all look alike to us. Well, that's one for our side.
Let's do it, man!
I got music in me.
Sing the song.
television city in Hollywood, it's Tony Orlando and Dawn, featuring Joyce Vincent Wilson and Thelma Hopkins, with tonight's guest, Adrian Barbeau, and special guest star, Freddie Prinze.
How'd it feel coming out singing and all that stuff?
Weird.
Yeah, a little strange?
Yeah, because I haven't done that before, you know. I plan to one day, but...
I'll tell you something. You surprised everybody in this room. I don't think anybody, aside from the fact that we got a little bit... He sings great!
Man, sings great!
There was two black dudes in the back, right? There's two black dudes in the back. One dude said, I didn't know the sucker could sing. And the other dude said, he can't. Good thing he's funny.
You know, this whole little talk that we're having here, Freddie and I said, well, if we're going to rap on the show, we're going to talk on the show, let's not prepare it. Let's just ask each other's question that we've been dying to ask each other for the longest time. And so that's what I'm going to do. I got to ask you one question, which is the whole basis of that opening that we did before. Do you really, like I do you really get Tony Orlando?
Yes. Yes, in the airports, in the restaurants, in the restrooms of America. People go, hey, man, you're Tony Orlando. I watch you, yeah. You know, this one guy, this dude in New York, Puerto Rican dude, came up to me, and he said, hey, Tony, man, how you doing? I said, fine. He said, man, if you see Freddie Prinze, man, tell that sucker I'm gonna kill him. He owes me $20. I started singing, tire, yellow, red. Pick two girls up off street. You wanna be done? Come here. God knew long ago.
Hey, I want you to know something. I shared something with the audience before they came out. I want to share it with the people at home. And it may sound redundant to everybody here in the room, but I want to share it with you at home. If I had a brother really born to me, you know, if I really had a brother born to me, and I didn't, I only had a sister, I would have wished to God that it was like this man right here.
Feelings mutual.
Norton,
hey, everybody.
You feel like getting funny, Norton, now and here?
I am radio captain for you.
Well, then, in that case, away we go. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Freddie Prinze.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. I don't know if Tony mentioned it this show, but Tony is half Greek, half Puerto Rican. That's true. I'm half Hungarian, half Puerto Rican. That's a Hungarican. I see there's only one Hungarian in the house holding the exit door open. That's a weird thing to be, too, as a Hungarican, because I couldn't figure how my parents met, you know, a gypsy and a Puerto Rican. I asked my mother. She said they were on a bus trying to pick each other's pocket. And my mother's great. She's a Cancer. She's a very romantic person. She's always talking about her wedding. Saying, oh, Freddy, the wedding was beautiful. Your father was so handsome. All the flowers, the music, the food. You should have been there. I was there. See, that's the thing, boy. Like, I grew up in New York from a Puerto Rican background. And like Tony was saying, you know, he gets recognized as me, and I get recognized as him. And different fans recognize you different. Like, old ladies grin a lot. You know, they go, you're you. You know, right? Black people take a few minutes to make sure they're right, you know. Is that my man? Television, yeah, uh-huh. Boom, yeah, boom, yeah, you got it. Right on, brother. Man, me and my old lady love you. Watch you every week on television. Mama, come in, meet Merv Griffin. My people recognize me too in the street. Hey, Freddie Prinze, good to see you. Making money now. I stick him up. See, people have the wrong impression of Puerto Ricans. To hear some people tell it, You think that we were responsible for cockroaches.
We didn't bring them here.
There was no guy in Puerto Rico with a jar of them for each of us. Okay, you release this in New York, you go to Chicago, Los Angeles, you know. And cockroaches are crazy, because they threaten you before you go out in New York. You know, where you going? To the store? Don't come back without no soda, we killed your mother. And you can't kill them, they're strong. You ever step on a roach, you hear them snap, as soon as you lift your foot, they run like hell. That's because they know that we think the snap means they're dead, and under our foot going, jerk! All kind of animals in the ghetto. I had a pet mouse, Oscar. I met Oscar in a strange way. I was midnight snacking. I'm sitting at the kitchen table, eating pound cake, drinking milk. I look across the table, and there's a mouse eating a hamburger, drinking a beer. So I said, hello. He goes, what's happening, baby? Obviously a black mouse. So I said, my name's Freddy, what's yours? He goes, Oscar the Lover, there is no other, and if there is, it is my brother. Then I noticed he had four mice behind him, all going, ooh. They got a singing group together and got right out of the ghetto. Animals are great, right? Now people are buying German shepherds for protection, you know, because German shepherds bark at the doorbell. You know. I bought a Puerto Rican shepherd. Very macho, right? You ring the bell, who is it? I tried to paper train him. I put newspaper in the bathroom, he'd go and sit on a bowl and read them. Low dog. See, I knew he was a Puerto Rican shepherd because if I took him in the street and he'd see a pool, he'd go, bow wow, honey, oye, mija, mami. Hey. Looking good. That's the thing, though, boy. Because the crime people are doing that. You know, people are taking kung fu class. And no, like, Chinese people don't get bothered anymore. Since kung fu movies came out, because you've seen them, they pull your eyes out and show them to you before you die. Voila! Used to go to the laundry. Had this for Saturday. Now it's whenever you have time. You have to wash it. Just wrap it up. That's all. I have a friend, Nat, who went to take kung fu. Nat's a black dude. He's about 7 feet tall. 1 foot of it is hair, 1 foot is platform shoes, and that's about this big. And so Nat goes to take kung fu from this little old Chinese man, Mr. Wang. Right? He goes in the first day, say, Mr. Wang, brother, I want to take some kung fu. Wang goes, what up? If you know kung fu, you'll be able to avoid that. Yeah, well, no fooling, Sherlock. Well, listen, man, I want to take some class. Can I get in the class here, man? He goes, what up? And if you don't know kung fu, you're able to avoid that. And that's a ch-ch-ch. If you knew my people, you'd be able to avoid that.
Thank you. Like an eagle protects his nest. For you I'll do my best. Stand by you like a tree. I dare anybody to try and move me.
Darling, in you I found strength where I was torn down. Don't know what's in store. Together we can open any door.
Just to do what's good for you and inspire you a little higher. I know you can make a man out of a soul that didn't have a goal. Cause we got the right foundation. And with love and determination, you're all I need. Oh, to get alive.
Think it is? Well, Joyce, if you're thinking that is who I'm thinking that is, I think I'm gonna faint.
Scooby Dooby Doo. Da 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 da. Scooby Dooby Doo. La 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 la. Hiya, broads. Scooby Doo. Chicky, sweetie. And a ring-a-ding-ding.
Look out, Joyce.
It's the Avon lady.
Do I or do I not remind you of the man?
Yeah. Where's Chico?
Well, you know who I am. I mean, look. Frank. Huh? Frank.
Frankenstein! He sings like he's got a bolt through his neck.
You think a silly little put down like that could bug the chairman of the board, huh?
Tony, yeah. Why do you want to be Frank Sinatra?
Because Sinatra is a living legend, Joyce. I mean, I hope someday the name Orlando will mean something like his.
What are you worried about? You've already got a city in Florida named after you.
I want to go out on stage, folks. Really, I do. Go into my song and, like, just like Frank, and have the women fall down. Strangers in the night. All right, what are you doing?
Oh, Frankie, we're swooning.
us away, baby.
And not a moment too soon. Come on, girls, will you get up off the floor?
Get up? I haven't been this weak in the knees since Billy D. Williams autographed my frisbee.
All right. Come on, get up. Come on. Come on, get up. I'm serious now, all right? I mean, look, I guess I'm going to have to show you, right?
That was fun.
Nobody smokes a cigarette like Sinatra. Nobody has a trademark like Sinatra. You know what this finger snapping is? It's very important.
Sure is. It's keeping the audience awake.
Girls, you tinkle before we leave.
My story is much too sad to be told, but practically everything leaves me totally cold. The only exception I know is the case when I'm out on a quiet spree, fighting vain. Then I suddenly turn and see your fabulous face. I get no kick from champagne. Mere alcohol doesn't thrill me at all. So tell me, why should it be true that I get a kick out of you? Some like a rock type refrain. I'm sure that if I heard even one riff, that would bore me to rip thickly too. Yet I get a kick out of you. Sing the song, chicks.
I get a kick every time I see you
standing there before me. I get a kick, though
it's clear to see
you obviously do not adore me.
Oh, I
get no kick in a plane. Flying too high with some gal in the sky is my idea of nothing to do. Kick gives me a boot.
I get a kick
out of you.
Right back with Tony Orlando and Dawn.
I guess it was yourself you were involved with. have sworn it was me. I might have found out sooner if you'd only let me close enough to see. That ain't no way to treat a lady, no way to treat your baby, your woman, your friend. That ain't no way to treat a lady, no way, but maybe it's a way for us to end. I was only being a picture with all the colors that I know, while you were busy looking into wide blue mirrors and loving the show. That ain't no way to treat a lady, no way to treat your baby, your woman, your friend. That ain't no way to treat a lady, no way, but maybe there's a funny kind of consolation keeping me sane, and I'd really like to share it, crawl on deep in my brain, and see the times you never felt me loving you or needing you, so leaving you now, you still won't know how to feel the pain. That ain't
Remember those wonderful old road pictures with Bob Hope and Bing Crosby?
You know, like The Road to Zanzibar, The Road to Morocco, and The Road to Singapore.
Well, tonight, we're taking a little detour.
That's right. It's Orlando and Friends on The Road to Puerto Rico.
Man, this is the last time I let you take me on a Caribbean cruise. I've heard of no frills, but this is ridiculous.
What are you complaining about? We're here, aren't we? Puerto Rico, the land of our forefathers.
Yeah, and don't forget our two mothers.
You know what? I got a feeling our act is going to be dynamite here, with me singing My Sweet Gypsy Rose.
Yeah, my comedy act, yeah. Hey, folks, you know what a Puerto Rican charge account is? Dollar down and change your address.
You gotta say we're like good stuff for the act. That's right, because there's a whole big, beautiful island out there just for you and me.
Vámonos.
Yes.
We're off on the road to Puerto Rico, which could be the road to romance. With native girls all around us, we'll be having fun in the land of cha-chas, cucarachas, and the tropic sun. Tell the gang so they won't hang around. It's Tony and it's Chico, Puerto Rico bound.
Ay, 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 I like me fair.
much. Oh,
Rosita.
I think I'm grand.
Rosita, cool it.
Wait, one more. Oh. Okay, what do you want?
Do you see those two idiots over there? Our job is to Shanghai them to work in the El Sliso Club as bus boys.
What happened to our Puerto Rican bus boys?
They're all working in New York. Go ahead, do your stuff.
Oh, I can't do that to those two innocent guys, Rico. I am not a con artist. I am a dancer.
How would you like to dance with a cast on each leg?
Two bus boys to go. I like me very much. I think
hey,
I'm grand.
Hey, all that honey over here.
Hey, man, that's no way to talk to a lady, you crude, tasteless lout.
Hey, honey, meet our mommy over here.
Buenos dias, senores. I am Rosita with the San Juan Welcome Wagon.
Well, I don't know about your welcome, but I sure like your wagon. Bob Hope, 1937.
Step aside, Junior. Can't you see that the lady's got eyes for me?
Don't waste your time with him, honey. I'm the talented one. I come from a long line of entertainers.
Yeah, I know that line. It's standing in front of the unemployment office.
Performers.
That's right, singer and comedian.
That's right. Dig this. Tie a yellow ribbon around the old oak tree.
Oh, then you must be the singer.
Wait a minute. Hold it there. I want you to know that that record sold over 6 million copies.
Well, so much for America's taste.
Listen, calm down, muchachos. Let me give you our famous San Juan welcome drink.
Ooh. Look at that, a San Juan stinger. All he needs is little pom-poms and fuzzy dice over here and a little dog in the back with the head going up and down.
Hold it. I'm a little worried about this drink here. Look at this. The banana is peeling itself.
Mm. Oh, no. Drink up. I give you the magic of the island.
I don't know.
I also give you my phone number.
Salud!
Wow.
Come on, Mama. We're going out on the town.
Hey, man.
Yeah?
I think we just got our first taste of Puerto Rican Gatorade.
With the real gator in it.
I think Tony and Freddy deserve an award for this. Do they give an Emmy for gall?
Man, you and your big ideas. They've had us working night and day in this slop hole for the last 2 weeks.
What are you complaining about? We've got a roof over our head and something to eat.
Oh, you like it so much? Stick out your hand. I'll scrape you a second helping.
Easy, man. Even your new blue cheer's getting depressed.
Listen, Hey, careful. Here comes the boss. Act busy.
Okay, you guys. I want you to stop goofing off and get to work. Or I'll have Rico play Tico Tico on your Bico. Yeah.
And that Rico plays rough.
Yeah, I hate those massages with the rusty Brillo.
Don't worry about it, pal. Don't worry about a thing. I'll handle her in my usual captivating way.
Moonlight becomes you. It goes with your hat. You certainly know the right thing to wear.
I can't go on with this, man.
Can't go on with it. Bing did it?
Yeah, but he had Dorothy Lamour in a sarong. I've got Cannon in a body stocking.
I've had it with both of you. By the time you get out of here, your hands are going to have more wrinkles than Columbo's raincoat.
That's what she thinks. Plan three.
Check. Hey, Mama, you're wasting us in this kitchen.
Yeah, we got a great act. Just watch.
Hey, all right.
Hey. You know what? How many sheep does it take to make a sweater?
I didn't even know sheep could knit.
How about a little shuffle off to Buffalo?
Yeah.
Head for the door.
Right.
One more time.
You are out of time. I'm through fooling around with you.
Well, what do we do now?
The one thing that always works.
Unos, dos, tres.
Patty cake, baker's man. Bake me a cake as fast as you can.
She's not a woman, she's a Jeep. Otra vez.
One more time.
Patty cake, baker's man.
You hit her in the head.
And I'll kick her in the cat.
I'm going to tie your two lips together, and then I'm going to bump you off.
Somebody's going to get bumped off, all right, but it ain't going to be them.
1 o'clock. Time for my siesta.
I got 2 airplane tickets to New York. One for me and one for the man I love.
Well, sorry about that, Junior. You win some and you lose some.
Wait a minute, burrow brain. What makes you think she wants you? This girl obviously has taste, class, good judgment. She most likely wants me.
No, me.
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 Me, 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 me.
I'm so glad you chose me.
Oh, Tony, we've been married 3 years now, and you're the only man I ever loved. And now we have this beautiful little baby.
Mira, mami, dame leche. Hey, sweetheart, give me some milk. I'm thirsty, I'm hungry. Wow!
Take it home, brother! Take it home! Ah. Yeah. Woo. Listen to that band! Cooking! Ho! Oh. Oh, I met my little brother dog down by the riverside. Down by the riverside. Down by the riverside. Listen here. Oh.
a stop, huh? All right. Hi there. What's your name?
Mike Halverson.
Hiya, Michael.
Hi.
You didn't think you'd be in this position tonight, did you?
No.
Does it make you kind of nervous, Michael?
Not really.
Good. What do you feel like doing, Mike?
You really want to know?
Yeah.
I really don't know.
Well, you've been standing online before you got into the show a long time, and you've been sitting here a long time. Michael, I got a feeling I know where you want to go.
Oh, I know too.
Well, come on, Michael. Let me see you get down and soulful, Michael. Come, he's ready. Look at this guy. He wants to get up and do it. You want to do the same? Yeah. Well, yeah.
Well, yeah.
Said I'm gonna sing my song, Tony, yeah.
I'm gonna sing my song, Tony.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
What a man is cooking. Look out, the man's gonna be cooking. He's there and he's ready to go. I can see his coat's coming off. You know something, Michael? Do you know what it feels like when we introduce our guests to come through that panel over there? No. You know what it would feel tonight? When the opening of the show was my first time, and all the time that I've been doing this show, that I had the opportunity to walk through that, and it's like coming off in the wrong floor in the elevator. You know what I mean? It's like all of a sudden, oh, I think this is the wrong place. I want you to see what's your whole name, Michael?
Michael Halverson.
Michael Halverson.
Halverson.
Halverson. Michael Halverson, I want you to know what it's like to be a guest on the Tony Orlando and Dawn show. Thelma Hopkins, Joyce Vincent Wilson. Michael, you just sneak on back there, and I'm going to give you an introduction, and you come in through that place just like I did, and you take your bows. Ladies and gentlemen, I am proud and honored to say that here on our show tonight, on our stage, and I dare Howard Cosell to find this guy. Okay. Would you please all welcome one of the great silent stars that yet we have come up to whatever. How did you like my dialogue so far? Is that good? Now, those of you at home, this man does something that no other person does better than this man I'm about to introduce to you right now. And you saw him come out of this audience. There is nobody in this business that can do, now dig this, there is nobody in this business that can do nothing, but I mean nothing, better than Michael Halverson. All right? Michael, welcome to the show, Michael. Come on up here, Mike. Michael, I've heard that you are absolutely fantastic at doing nothing. Is that true?
Yes.
Okay. Then, Michael, here's the microphone in your hand. Look straight out at about 50 million people. Stand here and let me see how well you do nothing. Look at that, Michael. I'm giving you a standing ovation. I can't believe that, Michael. Look at that. I don't believe this. That's all for you, Michael. Congratulations. And all I can say is from the bottom of my heart, Michael, you were the best guest that did absolutely nothing on this show that we've ever had. And people who do as well as you, like I did with my brother Freddie Prinze, deserves this. You all, and thank you for a whole lot of fun.